Hello, family, friends, community members, staff, and a special hello to you, the graduating class of 2020. The following presentation is our senior awards presentation. These awards are for the students that not only met the graduation requirements, but went above and beyond during their time here at Apopka High School. So to you, I say, job well done. Typically, I don't speak at senior awards night, and I don't speak because I like to be out front to be the first to give you a handshake and congratulate you and hand you the award. But different times call for different measures. So in this time, I will still be the first to say, congratulations to all of you on your hard work and accomplishments. And I will finish by saying with a different traditional greeting and say, Namaste. Enjoy the presentation.
And now the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the hearts of all the students who attend these hallowed halls, there are thoughts of sweet devotion.
I would like to welcome you all to the Class of 2020 Senior Awards. I'm Mr. Mellon. This is definitely unique for all of us. It is different. It is weird staring out at an empty auditorium. We miss you greatly. I also am having issues. I put my vest on earlier and realized I picked up the Corona 15. Hopefully you guys are doing better with that than I am. Tonight, or today, whenever you watch this really, we're gonna be celebrating the achievements of the Class of 2020. You guys have done some amazing things. Parents, if you're watching, and hopefully you are, you realize these kids have put us in a good place. Looking at everything that's going on during the quarantine, it seems to be the young kids that are handling it much better than us old kids. So sit back. I would tell you normally at this time when you could come up and take pictures. You won't have to. You can record this whole thing. You can sit back, have some snacks, pause when you need. So while it is sad that you're not here, there are some advantages to being distant. For me, it is really difficult because there's no energy in here and there's an echo. So without any further ado, I again want to welcome you to the Class of 2020 Senior Awards. We're going to do things a little differently tonight. We're going to start with our most prestigious awards. We're going to start with our class's top 10 list. So, without any further ado, starting at number 10. And yes, I'm getting old. I need my reading glasses. Coming in at number 10, Alyssa Van Tine. Number 9, Lauren Lambert. Number 7, Tide, which is perfect for these two young ladies, Marissa Dean and Elena Dean. Number 6, Jameson Stovey. Number 5, Jordan Jenkins. Number 4, Jonathan Gardone. Number 3, Jackson Davis. Number 2, your class salutatorian, Janelle Fernando. And your class valedictorian, number 1, Marla Horn. These children have put in some incredible work. Their grades show it. Their effort has shown through. On a personal note, I would like to point out that of this top 10, I have had 8 of them. So any of you that are underclassmen and are shooting to be in the top 10, just keep that in mind. Without any further ado, let's move on to our other awards this evening.
Hello, my name is Christina Roberts, and I'm here to speak on behalf of the Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority. Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority is pleased to announce the recipient of their $1,000 scholarship called the Petals of Hope Foundation Scholarship. This year's recipient is Layla Rains. Congratulations, Layla.
Hi, my name is Amy Barber, and I'm from the Atkins Educational Foundation. Our competitive Pathway to Success program guarantees that our first-generation recipients will have their full cost of attending college covered for their 4-year program. Now, this is more than just tuition. This is housing, food, clothes, books, and all the other little things that build up and make college more difficult to afford. We also provide mentoring for our students to help them navigate the new world that is college. Our committee was extremely impressed with this year's recipient. Not only has she excelled academically, but she has continuously proven her dedication to service and leadership, traits that we are certain she will take with her to the University of South Florida next year. We are so excited to see what she achieves. Congratulations to our 2020 Pathway to Success Scholar, Alexis McIntosh.
Hello, darters. On behalf of the Bridges to Success Scholarship Program, I am honored to present the Valencia College Bridges to Success Awards for 2020. The scholarship committee received over 993 scholarship applications. Of those, 164 scholarship recipients were selected. Of the 164, Apopka is proud to have 4 scholarship recipients. Way to go, darters. This award is given to students who have dedicated themselves to their academics, community service, and extracurricular activities, despite any challenges that may have come their way. The Bridges to Success Scholarship is a full tuition scholarship, which also includes books. This scholarship is worth well over $6,000 a year for each recipient. So without further ado, I'd love to congratulate Maurice Barnes, Mitzi Martinez, Josh Regine, and Zarira McDowell. We are so proud of you, darters.
Greetings. I am Erica M. Scott, a proud graduate of the Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University. I am here to present scholarships to 2 deserving seniors on behalf of the Greater Orlando Chapter of Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University National Alumni Association. Florida A&M University was established on October 3rd, 1887 on the highest of 7 hills in Tallahassee, Florida. The Greater Orlando Alumni Chapter will give a total of $7,000 in scholarships to seniors in the Orlando area who have been accepted and plan to attend Florida A&M University. In the spirit of excellence with caring, it is a privilege and a pleasure to present Paige Grubbs and Cambria Mitchell a $1,000 scholarship each on behalf of the Greater Orlando Chapter of the Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University National Alumni Association.
The Jason Beard Memorial Foundation Scholarship was established by the Jason Beard Memorial Foundation to honor the life and legacy of my late husband, Jason Beard. Jason was diagnosed at age 37 with multiple myeloma, which is a cancer of the blood plasma cells and is quite uncommon in young persons. Jason passed away in March 2013 at the age of 42. He was a man of many attributes, a hard worker, passionate athlete, and caring father. He never let cancer be an excuse not to live life to the fullest. This year, the Jason Beard Memorial Foundation awarded 10 $1,000 scholarships to Orange County graduating high school seniors who have faced adversity in their lives, yet despite these challenges, plan to pursue a post-secondary education. The foundation received many outstanding applications and equally impressive recommendations, which made the selection process very competitive. The foundation is pleased to award $1,000 scholarships to the following Apopka High School students: Ariana Bikas and Harley Hansen. Your hard work and determination in school, as well as overcoming difficult circumstances outside the classroom, made you ideal candidates for this award. Congratulations to both of you.
Hi, Blue Darter seniors. This is Houston. I would first like to start off by congratulating you on completing your senior year in high school. This year, I had the privilege of serving as the sponsor for the Interact Club, and I have five young ladies that are truly deserving of the awards they are about to receive. The first award I would like to present in the amount of $1,500 goes to Nariah Anthony. The second award that I would like to present goes to Ajanelle Jones in the amount of $1,500. The third award I would like to present goes to Barbara Clerger in the amount of $600. The fourth award I would like to present goes to Niali Alvarez in the amount of $600. Niali, I apologize if I pronounced your last name incorrectly. The fifth and final award goes to Brianna Chambers in the amount of $600. Ladies, you have done an amazing job with helping me as my first year as a sponsor of the Interact Club, and I look forward to hearing your success stories in the upcoming years.
Hello, I'm Christy Woods from the Retired Educators Association of Orange County. 40 years ago, our organization purchased a housing complex for retired teachers, which was sold, the money invested, and the interest funds three scholarships through the Retired Educators Foundation of Orange County, affiliated with the Retired Educators Association. Its sole purpose is to fund three scholarships: the educators, $2,000 for teachers working towards a master's degree, the technical, $1,000 for students attending Orange Technical College, and the academic scholarship, $2,000 for graduating seniors with proven academic excellence and leadership in extracurricular activities and community service. It is my pleasure to present the Retired Educators Foundation of Orange County academic scholarship to Apopka High School senior Elena Dean. Congratulations to Elena.
Hello, I am First Sergeant Andreas, Senior Marine Instructor of the Apopka GRTC program. I am here today to announce the recipients of the Marine Corps Scholarship Funds. This year we have three recipients, and the recipients are Katrina Cologne for a scholarship of $2,000, Malaya Bowden for a scholarship of $1,000, and Yesenia Perez for a scholarship of $929. Congratulations, recipients, and good luck for the future. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Christina Roberts, and I'm the College and Career Specialist here at Apopka High School. Today, it's my privilege to be able to announce the Valencia College Associate of Arts degree recipients. This year we had 16 total students who were able to earn their AA degree while still in high school. It's very hard and takes a lot of work to be able to earn your Associate of Arts degree while still in high school. It takes about 60 credit hours of college courses, which ends up being about 20 classes total. So this year our recipients are Elena Dean, Marissa Dean, Janelle Fernando, Shanika Fevrier, Jonathan Gardone, Harley Hansen, James Henderson, Lauren Lambert, Soraya Letson, Anne Nguyen, Falana Nguyen, Lanai Powell, Bayla Samuels, Jameson Stobie, Alyssa Van Tyne, and Kaylin Boissel. Congratulations.
Tonight, I have the honor of recognizing the Agriculture Achievement Award for the Agriculture Department. The recipient of this award is a person who has been in agriculture and FFA for the past 7 years, starting out at Apopka Middle School and moving on to us 4 years ago. The recipient also has earned their Green Hand chapter, and this summer will earn their state FFA degree, which is given out by the Florida FFA Association. In the summer, it will be in a virtual convention. This person has worked hard for the past 4 years, and I'm extremely proud of this person. It is my honor to recognize the Agriculture Award to Mr. C.J. Christopher C.J. Nelson. Congratulations.
Hello, class of 2020. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Susan Townsend. I'm one of the medical magnet teachers, and it is my pleasure today to present the award for the Outstanding Medical Magnet Senior in the class of 2020. Most of you guys I had way back when you were freshmen, first coming into Apopka, and so it's been a while. I've had the pleasure of watching you grow into these amazing young people that are off and ready to take on the world. So trying to choose one of you was not an easy task, but there was one that stood out the most to me. I recently got an email from her telling me that she had been accepted to 20 different colleges and that she had chosen to attend Fisk University. So it is with tremendous pride and pleasure that I announce to you that the Medical Magnet Senior for the class of 2020 is Miss Ornelia Campbell. Congratulations, Ornelia. I can't wait to see what you do at the next level.
Hey, class of 2020, Dr. Hammond's here. I just wanted to take a moment and say how proud I am of all that you've accomplished in your high school career. I wish you the best as you graduate. Congratulations.
We're out here trying to figure out who the 2020 Engineering Magnet Student of the Year is. We didn't know what we'd do, so Ms. Meyer and I got together and said, hey, let's do a search mission with the drones. Ms. Meyer, did you check the METAR?
I did check the METAR. Winds are out of the east at about 5 knots, so we're good to go.
We're good to go, so we're gonna fly. We got the Inspire 2 here, we got the Mavic over there, we got the Mavic Mini here. Emily's there.
So we got Mini Meyer heading up to Northrop side of the campus. We got Big Meyer checking out the parking lot. Nothing there. Max sends the Inspire. It's going up and checking the campus. Nothing in the classroom in a dry dock. Can't find anything there. We'll swarm on over to the hangar, see what's going on in the hangar. We're gonna go back and try and land. I see something. That might be it. Looks like we have found the Engineering Student of the Year.
So with the help of the Mavic and the Mini, our mission was successful. We found the Engineering Student of the Year.
So congratulations, Marla Horn. Good luck at the University of Florida. I'm sure you will do well.
Every teacher yearns for a student who loves their subject matter as much as they do. Not every teacher is lucky enough to work with such a student for all 4 years of their high school career. Our Senior English Award goes to a young man who was a born reader and writer, but that natural talent has not stopped him from constantly pushing himself to grow in those areas. He has excelled in every English class he's ever taken, including a summer institute at the prestigious University of Chicago. This year, he headed up the National English Honor Society as its president. It has been my honor to see how far Jordan Jenkins has come, and I can only imagine how very far his talents and his hard work will take him.
Hey, 2020. It's your favorite daughter assistant principal here, Dominique Ryan, to wish you success and happiness in everything you do. It's been fun watching you grow. My blessings to all of you.
Today, I am presenting the Unique Achievement Award.
This award goes to a student who has made great progress this school year and has been successful in areas of academics as well as vocational training. This year's winner is St. Brian Drayton. Brian always goes above and beyond with everything asked of him. He has ventured out of his comfort zone this year, trying new classes and teachers, and has excelled. He participates in Special Olympics and is a huge Blue Darter sports fan. Congratulations, St. Brian Drayton.
Hello, Blue Darters. Boy, I am so glad I do not work in television. Do you know how many times I've recorded this? Too many. And I don't even know if this one is right. But I'm hoping it is because, I mean, I've had a lot of practice, like 50, maybe more. But here goes. My name is Ms. Venezuela. I'm the ELL compliance specialist at Apopka High School, and I am presenting the ELL award. This year's recipient is Lorena Infante. This young lady is a true go-getter and very talented. She came to Apopka High School only 2 years ago and learned English very quickly and began taking AP courses. Anything she sets her mind to, she does, and she does it very well, all of it. She has a big heart for helping others. She's very likable, and she gets along with everyone. She always has a smile on her face. All her teachers say she is a pleasure to have in class. She always strives for the best, not only in her classes, but everything she does. She has big goals, and I know she's going to reach every single one of them. We will surely miss Lorena's contagious energy and her beautiful smile. Lorena, congratulations. You deserve this and much more. I wish I were there to give you this award personally, but I'm sending a virtual hug, and please stay in touch. God bless you, and keep up the good work.
The Blue and White, our school newspaper, is a tight-knit group of dedicated individuals with strong personalities. All but one of them is a senior this year. This year's Journalism Award for Newspaper goes to a young man whose leadership truly turned the Blue and White into what it is today. From designing the publication platform to artfully writing articles and performing admirably as a respected staff editor, Jordan Jenkins is the Blue and White. His influence will live on in its pages.
Hi, this is Ms. Springer, and I'm here to present the Outstanding Yearbook Senior Award. And that award goes to Kayla Palmer. She was only on staff for 1 year, and a year cut short at that. But within that year, she contributed so much to the yearbook publication. She's a good writer, she's a good photographer, she is a good leader. The students really looked up to her, and I don't know what I would have done without her on staff. Not seeing her smiling face in the morning is something I'm going to miss a lot. So Kayla Palmer, you deserve this award. I know you're going to go on to do great things. Thank you.
Hello, class of 2020. This is Mr. Smart. First of all, I'd like to congratulate you on your accomplishments. And secondly, I'd like to wish you the best of luck in whatever the future holds for you.
Hello, my name is First Sergeant Dreher, and I am the senior instructor of the JRTC program. And I am here today to announce our Outstanding Senior of the Year. Our Outstanding Senior of the Year is Amaya Rice. Amaya Rice is our battalion commander, which means she's responsible for 208 cadets. Amaya has led these cadets with fairness, firmness, motivation, and dedication. She's been a part of all of our community service activities, and she has maintained a 3.6 weighted GPA. Amaya is also the commander of our armed drill team. She has led our armed drill team into 4 drill team competitions, placing no less than 3rd in each of them. Amaya has assisted us in becoming back-to-back regional drill team champions. Amaya is an outstanding cadet, and we would not have been able to accomplish all that we've accomplished this year without her. Therefore, it would just make sense that Amaya Rice would be our outstanding senior.
This year's Outstanding Math Award recipient is Ms. Elena Dean. Elena is enrolled in both AP Statistics and AP Calculus BC, and she maintains top grades in both classes. As a junior, she took AP Calculus AB and scored a 5 on that exam. Both Ms. Wiesian and myself consistently witnessed her unparalleled work ethic and unmatched leadership skills in and out of the classroom. I wholeheartedly agree with Ms. Wiesian when she says her drive for knowledge is unlike any I have taught before. Her work ethic is nothing short of excellent, no matter what the challenge, and she is equally as willing to assist those around her. She is thorough, thoughtful, and enthusiastic in everything she does. Elena has also been actively involved in Mu Alpha Theta, the National Math Honor Society, for the past 2 years, and she is currently serving as our vice president and has well over 30 hours of tutoring and working to improve the math culture of Apopka High School. She is mathematically talented beyond compare. I am certain that it has been every math teacher's absolute honor to work with her. I feel particularly blessed to have worked with her and most definitely honored to have taught her AP Calculus for the past 2 years. We love you, Elena. You are more than one in a million. You are one in infinity.
Hi, daughters. Ms. Owens here. I want to congratulate the class of 2020. I'm extremely proud of you. In the words of Dr. Seuss, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So daughters, get on your way. As always, daughter strong, daughter pride.
Thank you to all of our senior members for the incredible work you've done in making our performing arts what it is today. Without your hard work and dedication, we would not be where we are at this point. I'd like to say thank you for the spirit and honor that you brought to each of your respective performance areas. There's some incredible things that's taken place each of the last 4 years, and it's largely in part because of you and your commitment to what we're doing as a community. We would like to recognize our male Performing Arts Senior of the Year. This young man has been exemplary for each of his peers as a role model in showcasing what growth and development looks like as an individual musician through his performance in all state, all county, district and state solo and ensemble, but also as a servant leader for his peers, being a great role model and showing what it means to go above and beyond, not only to empower and help others, but also to seek out performance opportunities outside of our program to further develop his skill and craft. We would like to recognize Mr. Matt Murphy and say thank you for all that you've done for our program and for being a great role model for each of our members. Congratulations, Matt.
Congratulations to this year's Outstanding Performing Arts Female, Marissa Dean. We are so proud of you and can't wait to see you on the big stage.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. McWithy here. I'm going to talk a little bit about the robotics program here at Apopka High School. A lot of things we've done, including this year's VEX competition, Tower Takeover. We had many successes. 6 teams went to the state tournament. We also hosted the first ever RAD drone racing competition. And in all those competitions, our students represented Apopka High School very well.
Hey guys, we're in quarantine here at the McWithy House. Get an email that says, hey, we need a video to nominate and determine the 2020 Robotics Student of the Year from Apopka High School. So I thought, we've done a lot of good things. We can be creative here at the McWithy House. We had the VEX Robotics in the first semester and our teams did very well. Team 550 was phenomenal. We had all 6 teams qualify for the states. I think we did extraordinarily good there. We moved on to the Lockheed Martin competition held at Lockheed Martin. We've won that almost every year and this was no different. We finished first and second and our teams represented Apopka very well. From then we move into the underwater robotics, and in underwater robotics you build something to go underwater. It uses a camera and the camera goes underwater so that we can see what it was. So I thought, I'll take and put the name of the student who is our robotics student of the year on two of our objects from VEX this year, and then I will use the camera to identify that. So let's go over and check out our ROV camera. So here's our control panel. Here's our ROV camera. Who'd have thought that the students at Apopka High School will build an ROV and their camera doesn't work? Not me. So I guess what's left to do? I guess I'm gonna have to go down, fetch the objects, and figure out who that student is. I'll be back in a little bit. Oh, see, it's 5:50, but we're going down there. Nick Shea and no Speedo, that's a wrap.
Congratulations, Nick. We appreciate all you've done for Apopka Robotics, and we know that great things are in your future, and you will represent us all very well. Thank you, Nick Shea.
The stellar recipient of this award is a remarkable student that has a unique combination of talents. This student has demonstrated superior academic skills combined with leadership and community service. The student not only demonstrated a strong work ethic, but was able to develop and maintain a program that assisted our community and demonstrated good environmental concern for our community. Academic excellence coupled with leadership and program initiatives makes this recipient stand out from her peers. Now it gives me great pleasure to proudly present the Senior Science Award to Cecilia De Jesus Reynoso.
Hi, I'm Brian Blevins. I have the distinct honor of presenting the Social Studies Department Student of the Year Award. Social Studies is the academic discipline associated with humans in society. History, geography, government, economics, anthropology, the list is endless. There were several imposing candidates for this honor. One had to come out on top of this venerable group of students. I was fortunate to have this student in class twice, both for AP Capstone Seminar and AP Capstone Research. We discussed, we debated, sometimes outright argued, but we always found middle ground and compromised. His academic process is nonpareil, and his work ethic is second to none. He possesses a natural humility about his intellectual gifts, along with the quiet confidence that his work will make a difference. His capstone research project was 5,000 words on rethinking suburbia, exploring the relative associations between built environmental characteristics and social and societal capital, for which he received a coveted and rare 5 from College Board. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present Jordan Jenkins as the recipient of the Apopka High School Social Studies Department Student of the Year.
Greetings, everybody. My name is Mr. Peters, and I'm the SGA sponsor, and I'm here to give the 2 SGA Student Government Senior Awards out for this class of 2020. It's always a hard decision to make because so many of our seniors in SGA have been in the organization a few years and have done just a wonderful job. Every year I could give this award to several people, but hard choices have to be made. But I'd be remiss in not rewarding the 2 people that essentially this was a partnership from homecoming to Powderpuff to whatever thing that was planned this year, organization of everything, with these 2 individuals. And these 2 individuals are SGA Vice President Barbara Clerger, and SGA President Faith Evans. Thank you so much for all your service this year and everything you've done, and holding together while I was in the hospital. I can't thank you enough. I love you much. Take care.
I'm a blue darter. I'm a blue darter. Watching my peers go by.
Hi, I'm Matt Hooverus. Art is the greatest of subjects. Young artists create works of beauty and intelligence and depth while they try to develop skills and their own personal style. Apopka is filled with talented artists, from Jenna Luddy to Nick Gantz to Cece Martin to Marla Horn. In fact, the class of 2020 is the best class for the arts at Apopka in over a decade. Andy Warhol created works in a studio he called The Factory. The Artist of the Year would have fit in well there, for she is constantly producing, constantly working, and constantly improving. She has worked in what we call wrestling with the masters, gleaning ideas from Millet and Caravaggio and Elizabeth Figuier-Lebrun. She does more than just fulfill her assignments, even using her own hard-earned money to take live drawing lessons outside of school. Her talent, effort, and output have made her a most worthy recipient of this award. On behalf of Ms. Carrie Leifers in the Art Department, I am happy to present the Art Student of the Year Award to Ms. Jamie Williams. Congratulations, Jamie.
Hi, I'm Carmen Benitez, a Spanish teacher, and honored to present our Outstanding World Languages Student Award. Our chosen student is Lorena Infante Garcia. Lorena has taken 4 consecutive years of Spanish. She completed Spanish 1 for Spanish speakers, Spanish for Spanish speakers honors 4. She passed AP Spanish Lang with a 5. And she was my former student in AP Spanish Lit and Culture. She was a very, very hardworking student, enjoys participating in class and serving our community. In addition, Lorena was the vice president in our Spanish National Honor Society. On behalf of the World Languages Department, we are very proud to present our award to Lorena Infante Garcia. Felicidades, Lorena. Continue working hard. Sigue adelante con tu meta, que lo vas a lograr.
Hey there, class of 2020, it's Mr. Myers here. I just wanted to take a few moments to let you know how proud I am of each of you for all that you've accomplished in your educational careers. I look for nothing but the best out of each of you and wish you nothing but health and happiness moving forward. Again, all the best and congratulations.
Hi, my name is Kayla Weezian, and I am here to announce the Class of 2020's Outstanding Senior. This award is special for a couple of reasons. First, it has been awarded since 1932, and second, it is completely peer voted. Seniors were asked to vote for one individual who they believe exemplifies a true blue darter in every aspect of his or her high school career. Somebody who is hardworking, involved, enthusiastic, and kind. Somebody who will leave Apopka High School and go out to make the world a better place. As senior class sponsor, along with Ms. Leifers, we can confidently tell you that this group had a tough decision to make. These young men and women are truly extraordinary. I would like to thank every single senior from the class of 2020 and congratulate you all. Congratulations. With that said, it is now my honor to announce the class of 2020's outstanding senior with the most votes is Jonathan Gardone. Congratulations, Jonathan.
Welcome back. Congratulations again to all of you and all of the wonderful accomplishments from this class of 2020. I would like to make a personal congratulations to Jonathan Gardone, who was elected by his peers as the outstanding senior of the class of 2020. It's nice to be able to mention Jonathan on stage and not have to wear a bucket on my head. Thank you, Jonathan. We're getting ready to say goodnight and end our program. I am saying goodbye on behalf of all of your teachers and the administrative staff. I'm going to do it my personal way. Those of you that have had me, this might sound a little familiar, but it is slightly different. Once you make a decision, don't change that decision unless somebody gives you information that tells you you should change that decision. Throw your hands up. Do pass go. Collect all of those memories. And as always, good luck and Godspeed.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.